Welcome back to Robot Wants It All! Last time we finished up Robot Wants Puppy, and boy was the extra mode on that something else. We're taking a step down, and moving now to Robot Wants Fishy. Which Robot Wants Fishy Classic, I have played on this channel before. But with the addition of Easy and the remix, let's see what happens. So you can see, this is not a... Even though it's the Easy mode, this isn't a quick thing. Let's actually look at our mutators, because we got a few more. So what do these do? Enemies shoot a lot more, but their bullets are slow. Your bullets can zap them, and you can hold... Okay, no, I don't like that one at all. Enemies shoot more, but their bullets are slow. I'm curious what this hyper blast is. Let's try it on easy, just to see what it is. It is the year 20XX, and a couple days. Robot got a kitty. Then, seeking a friend for Kitty, he tracked down and narrowly escaped with a puppy. Much to his dismay, Kitty and Puppy do not get along. In a last-ditch effort to find the creature that Kitty can get along with, Robot follows a rumor of one of his friendly life forms. He rockets to Regulus 9, the most dangerous mining facility strewn with robot upgrades in the galaxy. Leaving Kitty and Puppy in cryostasis, he descends into the darkness alone. Robot wants Fishy. Well, at least Kitty and Puppy are doing their thing. So what is this? Does it do anything? Maybe it'll do more once I can attack. Okay, so we got plenty of enemies down here. No means of attack yet. There we are, a means of attack. So they take the same number of hits. I have no idea what this thing is. I don't know what's going on with this hyper blast because it is doing effectively nothing. So these crystals are just miscellaneous collectibles at this point. You can see there's one out of 20 in the corner. Collecting one of them gives you a little bit of time back if you want to speed run. That over there looks very nice, but I cannot collect it. I would simply die. We have yet to encounter an enemy that actually attacks. I mean, we've seen them. But I feel like without a good view, it's going to be hard to tell how difficult it's going to be to deal with them. I wonder if the Hyper Blast, like, cancels bullets or something. Does. Oh, my attack can actually also cancel bullets. Nice. I'm gonna be honest, that's not bad. Like, it gives you a means of dealing with the sheer number of bullets that are going to be around. I want up there. I don't know if I can get anything up there, but I want up there. Oh, I can get up there. That would be a damage upgrade. Okay, so what we collected was that little purple crystal, which we can come down here and install here, which now lets us teleport around. I don't remember if your attack canceled bullets originally. Okay, this guy, you just want to tick off, so he charges you, and then you can hit him in the butt. There's not a lot you can do underwater right now. So that's just going to be down there. So we can survive in water, but that still doesn't really help us. Controlling underwater is janky at best, and you can't attack yet. So we'll just come back to that later. Y'all want to come back down here where I can hit you? Okay, mostly cleared out. So these red blocks here are important, but we can't do anything with them yet. That is all underwater, which I could hop in and grab you. But there's not much else we can do down there. It's all mostly underwater, so there's not a lot we can do right now. So let's go ahead and, instead of trying to do something down there, just go die or something. So there's fishy up there. Okay, well, never mind. I guess we're going underwater. Let's take a quick look back here. I don't think there's anything we can do here, but you never know. Is really all we have is the... Yeah, we, like, don't really have anything. Yep, nothing over there, nothing up here. So, alright. I'll play your game. There's really nothing we could do over here. No, there wasn't, because that was just that room with a little bit of water down there. Okay, I'll play your game. So I mentioned last time about Metroidvanias and how they can kind of lead you around the map, giving you an interesting location to go to. When you backtrack, they can kind of point you in a good direction. Um, The big problem that I have with Robot Wants Fishy is due to the teleporter mechanic at the center. You kinda can't do that here. So sometimes it just becomes you got a new power up. You got a new power up, go everywhere. So a lot of what one could assume is not the best backtracking. Because now I have the double jump. Where do I use it? Who knows? I can't do anything else here. I know that much. There was an enemy in the way. Oh, I can go this way now. There was an enemy in the way. Without attacking underwater, there's not a lot I could do about him. I hit the jump button and you know it. I'm on a time limit. There weren't any bullets over there last time. Now there are. Look at that. Also, these snails are horrible enemies and I hate them because they don't die. You can hit them a few times and then they retreat into their shell, but they will never die. See, he just kind of popped back out. Don't think I can get up that way. Dang it! Okay, at least we've killed who we can. We've got that bat over there to worry about still. These robots are trouble. Well, I hit him like twice. It's not enough to kill him, but it's enough to do some damage. I've successfully done some damage. Dang it, I thought I'd clear that. Also, I see purple shots over here still. Where are those coming from? The bats don't... Oh, it's coming from the snails, who now also shoot out purple shots. Come back here, I'm gonna kick your butt. Okay, so I'm gonna wait for them to go up. Still in a bad spot! Okay, nothing else we can do there, but at least we got all of them out of the way. I wanted to kill him, but this is gonna be a lot easier for now. Okay, we did it. Cool. So that was the shield power up. It functions as easily as you'd think it would function. You can take one hit and your shield goes away. And now that we have a shield, we can go back down here underwater. We can bypass the first area, but because we have an enemy down here, we have to eat a hit to get rid of the shield. I'm actually not entirely confident that I can do anything. Yeah, because that's that. That's that. Like, I think we need the thing to be able to attack underwater before we can do anything here. Yeah, we do. Okay. Well, gotta look around, figure out where else it is that I'm supposed to go. Because if we can't attack underwater, then we can't do anything down there. So let's take another look up here, perhaps? I mean, there's a couple things up here I can get. I can get you, now that I have the double jump. And I can get you, now that I have the shield. I don't think there's anything else we can do. So we haven't been down this way in a while. Let's take a look down here. Okay, so you need the shield in order to get through here. I saw the boss down that way. Curious what was up this way. Bunch of crystals. Cool. Oh, you guys shoot now? Oh, butts. Okay, so you might as well focus down one of these two. Because once you kill one, the other one full heals. Hoping he doesn't do that very often. Okay, no, we're good. Okay, we got a lot of, like, loose baggage down here, so let's just clear that up. I don't know how we're gonna do this with the bullets everywhere. Because you can kind of do a dance. He moves so fast. You can kind of do a dance. When there aren't bullets everywhere. But yeah, normally this guy doesn't fire bullets at all. Oh, he fires bullets when he lands. I was facing the wrong way. What the crap? I mean, he'll die eventually, and then it's all good. May only be able to get one hit in. I think I got a pattern that kinda works. Of course, it helps if I, you know, land on the platform and don't jump into the bullet. Yeah, getting to be just a few too many bullets. Okay, well, we tried this on easy for a reason. It's almost dead. Though these bullets are starting to be a pain. Oh, thank heavens. Okay, now we can attack underwater. Little harpoons. You can fire them up and down and all around. Kind of neat. Also kind of a pain in the butt to hit stuff with it. Just like a little bit harder than it needs to be. So I'm going down here because I want to kill you. Oh, you can also press down to descend just a little faster. Hey, buddy, you want to come down where I can hit you? Sometimes it's hard to figure out why you're attacking in the direction that you're attacking in. And it feels like even though you may try to, like, turn your attack, it just doesn't solve the problem. So this is a pretty good spot to just kind of chill. You're gonna die because there's enemies down here, though, but otherwise you can just kind of tank the boss. Wanna come back down? Whatever. There we go. You can just chill right here. This works even if you don't have the bullet canceling. And I think this boss, I don't know what extra attacks he's using. He may just be shooting, like, an additional sphere of bullets or something. Sorry for the noise. If I let off, I'm gonna stop attacking in the direction that I'm facing. But this works even without the bullet canceling effect. Okay, fine. Are you coming back? Okay, he's coming back. Yep, there we go. I'm gonna wait, because I don't want to kill him while you can't tell what's actually going on. He turned around, which is why you can hurt him. The bullets that he fires out go in a set pattern, and even without the bullet canceling, they'll just hit this block right above your head. So you just can't get hurt here. But this is also lined up perfectly to hit his one weak point, which is that little dot. Anything else down here? And our prize is this. Our attacks emit explosions, which can destroy the red blocks. Not sure if the explosions cancel shots or not. You can do it everywhere, like here. Both attacks do it. The harpoon and your mines. Is there a red underwater here? Not here. I want to say there was one down here, though, so let me go check that real quick. Yeah, there was, right here. Is there anything else down here? I think we've got everything down here. Pretty sure we got everything up here, so I think this quadrant is just done. So we can get that now. Which, much like the ceiling cat, as long as you touch the ceiling and are holding down the jump button, you can now stick to the ceiling. Good for getting around. And I think that's it for here. So I think this quadrant is also done. I don't remember if there's anything else down here. We can effectively finish the game. Ah, there was something. Yeah, because we're 17 out of 20 for Jimmy Jams. I do think the maglock is actually more annoying than the ceiling cat. Because you don't have to hold the jump button in order to lock on. You need to be holding it in order to lock on, but then you can let go and you stay locked on. Which can be a little irritating when you're moving around in, like, tight little areas and like, oh no, I just want to jump up here. No, I didn't want to stick to the ceiling. Now what I'm doing is slightly convoluted. Okay, so back here. Okay, the explosions do actually cancel bullets. So I know I can come up here. Oh, there's our final two. That is our final damage upgrade. There's the star up there. So that's looking like almost everything left for us. So to get this, you gotta go up here so you can hook on that and still have your double jump. So you can do that. You need the bubble so you can get through here. And there's our star. And that's everything! There's more stuff here, but not in easy. So we can collect that, and we can collect fishy. Yay! Well, points are points. Okay, so that was easy. Played classic, why doesn't it have my score? Whatever. Oh, because it's counting me with the mutator. Well, I don't like that mutator anyway. I like that one though. No, I'm pretty sure I played whatever. Not important. Well, now that we've dove into fishy, take a brief look at game history. So after Robo Wants Kitty, sponsors on auction sites. Oh, yeah, ad revenue, that was actually a thing. And yeah, here's the thing, ad revenue is hot garbage. It always has been, and it always will be. The only reason anybody can make a living off of ad revenue is by having actual, like, hundreds of thousands, if not millions of views on them. Even on this channel, I do make an amount of money off this channel and off the ads on this channel, which do help out considerably, thank you very much. But the ad revenue is always effectively nothing. If you guys genuinely want to help out the channel, instead of worrying about blocking ads or whatever, I have a tip system set up. It's there when I'm streaming, it's there on the Twitch page, it's there on the About page, it's... like, even a couple bucks is probably better than your ads would have given me. So, there's that as an aside. Let's see here. Golden Age Flash game. Oh, so this was made after... I knew this was kind of recent, but it came out after Flash was... discontinued is the word I was looking for. Another 2 months. Again, relatively quick to turn around when you already have your basic engine. You just got to come up with some new abilities and stuff. Your attacking is a little more direct here, but it's still not as... It's still got something else to it, to give it something unique, where the way you lob the bombs instead of... like throwing your cat at them, but also instead of just, you know, you shoot them. In fact, it has a similar arc to throwing the cat, only it just does the damage when you hit. So it kind of removes the bad part of the cat. Let's see here, make it bigger and better, divided the map into six distinct zones. Yeah, involved a lot more backtracking. Yeah, exploring where to go and backtracking. But I don't necessarily agree that that's a good thing. Like, you can let people explore and give them places to explore and things to do, but also, I feel like it's not the best design to just go, you got a new ability, what do you do with it? Who knows? Have fun. Another thing I love was stupid puns. Okay. And this was the first one with achievements. Interesting. I'm not going to be hecking with achievements. I think most of them are like speedrun and challenge run related. Alright, so that was the history. So next time we'll take a look at Classic and also probably Fishy Wants Robot, which I have no idea what's going to be. So until then, everyone.